When cutting a length of hose, there are two terms used. Cut to length means cutting the hose to the length the customer requested. In this regard, a 50-footer would mean to cut a 50-foot length of hose. Overall length means the overall length of the assembly, including fittings. Here, if the customer wants a 50-footer, the assembly, including couplings, is to measure 50 feet. When an overall length assembly is requested, follow this example to determine hose cut length. It is very important to cut the hose end square. This can be done mechanically with various types of saws or manually with a hose knife or razor knife. If you are cutting the hose manually, it is recommended to wet the blade with Dixon coupling lubricant first. As you can see here, the process of cutting the hose is faster and easier with the coupling lube. Take a rag, as shown here, and clean out the debris before inserting the coupling. Compressed air from a blowgun will not clean the hose completely. If preformed band clamps, double bolt clamps, or any type of clamp without gripping fingers are used, the correct number of clamps must be installed. Reference the pressure recommendation chart in the Dixon catalog or the pressure recommendation slide chart for this information. Mark the hose for proper clamp placement. Clamp placement is just as important to the performance of the assembly as the tightness of the clamp. For shanks having serrations all the same size, like king combination nipples, place the shank next to the hose, simulating it being inserted. Mark the hose at the point of the last serration. Static round the hose when required. Using the helical wire, as shown here, is one of several ways to ensure proper static grounding. Always contact the hose manufacturer for proper static grounding techniques for that particular hose. When installing preformed band clamps or bands and buckles on a hose with a helical wire, make sure the clamp tail is pointing in the same direction as the helix, as per our illustration. As shown here, determine the direction the helical wire is pointing, then slide the clamps over the hose with the clamp tails pointing in the same direction. If the hose reinforcement member is made of textile, this textile material can draw in moisture, which can lead to premature assembly failure. By sealing the hose end, typically with rubber cement or shellac, contact the hose manufacturer for specific recommendations. To ease the fitting into the hose, lubricate the coupling shank and inside of the hose with an approved coupling lubricant. Dixon Valve and Coupling Company recommends using Dixon coupling lubricant found in the current catalog. When you pull the tape out, you will notice that it has two sides. One side is that of a standard tape measure. The other side is marked inches of diameter by 64ths. This is the side of the tape used for measuring hose OD. Notice the measurement line. Pull out a length of tape and form a loop with it, making sure that inches of diameter by 64ths is facing up. Also, it is easier to read the tape when the measurement line is on the bottom. Pull the tape tight, making sure the tape is flat against the hose. Now, let's take our reading. The measurement line is to the left of our reference number 32, so we will be counting down. 32, 31, 30. In this illustration, our hose OD is 2 3/64.
Dixon, the right connection.